If you travel by air or live by an airport, then most likely you've seen the Boeing 737. The aircraft type has a long history of being used by most major airlines around the world and is Boeing's bread and butter. However, the aircraft is rivaled by the Airbus A320 program, which according to sales, has caught up significantly to Boeing for the coveted title as the world's most successful commercial aircraft. The plane that'll lead into the future much depends on the most recent series of each type, specifically the Boeing 737 MAX and the Airbus A320neo family. So, how do they compare? Let's find out. We'll be taking on the role of an airline that's considering either the Boeing 737 MAX family or the A320neo family. We'll be looking at profitability and price rather than focusing on passenger comforts, since most airlines have their own special configurations. You probably already know that the Boeing 737 MAX was grounded after two fatal crashes. These incidents are absolute tragedies, and the plane was out of action for 20 months. Since the groundings, the jet went through rigorous testing and analysis overseen by aviation bodies such as the Federal Aviation Administration or FAA. For the sake of a fair comparison, we'll base this video on the current recovery climate. We've put all versions into one table and highlighted their capacity and range. The Boeing 737 MAX 7 on paper competes well with the A319neo, while the Boeing 737 MAX 8 and 9 rival the A320neo. Finally, the MAX 10 should go head-to-head with the A321neo. Some would assume that the A321neo easily beats off all competition with its vast range and large passenger numbers. However, more passengers mean more seats that all need to be sold to make that route profitable. More passengers equate to more weight and the requirement for more fuel, or else a reduction in range. The numbers sometimes don't add up for every airline, and so hopefully it's clear that the largest and highest range aircraft is not always the most cost-effective option. Looking at passengers, we can see that the A319neo carries more than its rival, the MAX 7. However, there are only 7 passengers more. If it was a short flight of only $100 per ticket, that's only $700 extra revenue. Likewise, the 737 can only fly an additional 100 nautical miles than the Airbus, which, without going into details about fuel efficiency, may imply better operational costs. In this comparison, it would appear that the MAX 7 beats out the A319neo. It's worth noting, however, that the MAX 7 has yet to enter service, while the A319neo only recently started flying passengers and has experienced poor sales. Next up, we'll put the A321neo up against the 737 MAX 10, since the latter has the closest amount of seats to the Airbus model. Altogether, the A321neo has a maximum capacity of 240, which trumps the MAX 10's offering. The plane also has a range that's 700 nautical miles greater than its rival. Therefore, a company that's in the market for a 200-plus capacity narrowbody may likely prefer to go for Airbus's solution. The main comparison is between the A320neo and the 737 MAX 8 and MAX 9. With a top-down perspective, we can see that the Airbus A320neo carries 2 more passengers than the 737 MAX 9. However, the MAX 9 flies 50 nautical miles more than its Airbus rival. This makes a comparison on range or passengers almost inconsequential and really showcases just how tight the competition is. Looking at the specifics, we can see that the 737 MAX beats the A320 with a higher maximum payload, 46,040 pounds versus 44,100 pounds. The Boeing jet also has a higher thrust power. The MAX 9 can also be reconfigured into a super-dense 220-seater variant, or in the case of the MAX 8, a 200-seater for Ryanair. The 737 MAX 8 can also carry more cargo than the Airbus A320, meaning more revenue for the airline. In summary, this means more lifting power, more room, and more flexibility for airlines. In this comparison, our winner is the 737 MAX 8 or MAX 9. When it comes to costs, here is the 2018 list price for each Airbus aircraft. A319neo, $101.5 million. A320neo, $110.6 million. A321neo, $129.5 million. Additionally, the 2019 list price of Boeing's offerings. MAX 7, $99.7 million. MAX 8, $121.6 million. MAX 200, $124.8 million. MAX 9, $128.9 million. And MAX 10, $134.9 million. As you can see, the Airbus models are actually cheaper if we compare these outdated numbers. If airlines had to pay these old and public list prices, then Airbus would have the advantage. However, pricing always comes down to secret negotiations, which include steep discounts. By the end of October 2019, Boeing recorded 15,136 orders for 737 models, including all of the type's variants. Meanwhile, its European rival recorded 15,193 orders for the A320 family. Airbus had been chasing Boeing for years, and the A320 had put it in close range of the US firm. However, by the end of 2018, the A320 family was still behind the 737 MAX by 400 orders. The aftermath of the 737 MAX accidents and groundings eventually caught up with Boeing and impacted its reputation. As 2020 came around, Boeing was reporting some alarming numbers. When it came to plane sales, the company recorded its worst record in over five decades as it revealed no new orders in January that year. The last time this happened at the firm was back in 1962. In contrast, at the beginning of this year, Airbus said that it was discussing further ramp-up potential for the A320 program above a rate of 63 planes each month. It was seeing a clear path to further raise the monthly production rate by one or two aircraft. This move would have meant that it could manufacture 67 jets each month within 3 years. Airbus CEO Guillaume Faury told CNBC the following in February. The direct competitor to the 737 MAX is the A320 in the Airbus family of products. And on the A320, as you know, we're sold out until 2025, so we have no real opportunity in the short term to offset the consequences of the grounding. However, the pandemic would soon shake up the aviation industry from top to bottom. This factor would significantly impact the business of both plane makers. From the start of 2020 through to the end of October that year, the figure of MAX orders cancelled or removed from Boeing's official backlog when applying strict accounting measures stood at 1,006 planes. Altogether, cancellations of the type, including units where purchasers converted one type to another, were at 436 planes. Yet the mood shifted once again. The MAX's return to the skies and the relaxing of travel restrictions have caused narrow-body models across the board to become incredibly busy this year. There were 375 net orders placed for MAX aircraft. The momentum has continued with 132 net orders this year. Nonetheless, the A320neo is still seeing substantial progress. There were 444 net orders in 2021 and 191 in 2022. The total record is as follows when using numbers from May 2022. The Boeing 737 MAX has seen 4,891 orders with 797 aircraft delivered. Meanwhile, the A320neo family has taken orders for 8,086 aircraft, delivering 2,259 jets. Altogether, the damage done over the last few years means it's hard for many to put the 737 MAX over the A320neo. However, the robust scrutiny that the plane has gone through since then reassures us that nothing like the previous catastrophes happens again. Therefore, in this post-recovery reality that we're covering in this video, the Boeing 737 MAX edges past the A320neo on paper when it comes to specifications. However, the Airbus A320neo family and the lower prices offered could make it an attractive choice for several carriers when shopping for a new narrow-body fleet, as long as they can wait out the significant backlog that's been generated. Both types will continue to be powerhouses within the short and medium-haul market for years to come. However, it looks like Airbus will have the edge over its rival in this field over the next decade at least. Out of the Boeing 737 MAX and the Airbus A320neo, which aircraft do you think is better when going up against each other? Do you believe that the 737 MAX will be able to repair its reputation after its reintroduction? Let us know what you think of the planes in the comments section. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.